Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here. It is Wednesday, June 11th, 2014. It is 7:30 a.m. on the East Coast right now, and stock index futures are down in the pre-market. Dow futures currently down about 70 points, so we are expecting some selling at the open, but we do have 2 hours to go before the market opens, so some news could come out to change that before 9:30 a.m. Let's get started this morning, taking a look at stocks, bonds, and currencies. Now, it was fairly quiet trading on Tuesday. No trend changes to report in the major indexes, currencies, or bonds that we follow. For the VIX, we traded into the channel yesterday, but actually closed slightly lower. We need to close above $11.98 to give us a trend change on Wednesday. Bonds traded lower yesterday. U.S. dollar back on track, trading higher. Euro trading lower. We saw a slight uptick in the Japanese yen. Canadian dollar was unchanged on Tuesday. There's the Dow slightly higher, S&P 500 slightly lower, inside day for the NASDAQ 100, inside day for the Russell 2000. Zacks Microcap had an inside day as well. We saw the TSX close higher yesterday, making a new high for this move. We saw U.S. bank stocks trade higher. Canadian bank stocks traded slightly higher, had an inside day on Tuesday. And there's the XAU starting to break out, and the TSX Gold Index is now back on a buy signal. So we are seeing money go back into gold and silver stocks. Next up, let's take a look at the commodity ETFs that we track. Now, while things were fairly quiet in the stock market yesterday, there's a lot more excitement in commodities. And while we don't have a trend change for copper, we certainly have one for the GLD, so we close just above the upper channel line. We can remain long the GLD until we see a close below 120.68. And I'm fairly excited about this opportunity in gold, as we've got platinum shooting higher yesterday. Now, platinum gapped higher. Unfortunately, we didn't get this trade. We traded up to the upper channel line yesterday, had an early warning buy signal, but no official buy signal, which would be a close above the upper channel line. Now, platinum usually leads gold, and so if platinum's shooting higher, then I think gold is going to follow. And we've got silver, the SLV, back on a buy signal as of Tuesday's close. I'm not excited about trading silver or the silver ETF, but I'm certainly excited about trading silver stocks. Looking at energy, we had crude oil move higher yesterday and came back during the day, so we're settling right around the May highs there. And last time I checked, crude oil was up in the pre-market this morning. A little pullback in gasoline and a big pullback in natural gas. So we've got natural gas back on a sell signal as of Tuesday's close. Let's finish off this morning's presentation with a quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts, starting with the VIX. The VIX currently down at the bottom of the panic zones. Pressure zone has formed. We are projecting higher prices here. It would be one thing to go up and retest the recent highs. It would be another thing to go up and break out above the 200-hour moving average, which is just coming in around the 1230 level at the moment. The first sign something new is happening, of course, would be an hourly close above 11.29 for the VIX, and that'll probably happen at the open on Wednesday morning. Now, the S&P 500, we're coming in on a right-side sell signal, but I talked about giving the market a little bit more breathing room, and so right now we're looking for an hourly close below 19.46 on the S&P 500. 37.77 on the NASDAQ 100. These are the cash indexes. We're not talking about the futures contract. These are the cash indexes. And for the XAU, an hourly close below 87 would tell us something new is happening to the gold and silver market. For the XAU, we've traded right up to the 200-hour moving average, and we're still projecting higher prices here, but of course that is a big line in the sand for the market to break through. Looking at the TSX, there we are trading through the top of the panic zones right now, certainly on an intraday right side buy signal. And if we want to give the market a little more breathing room on the downside, an hourly close below 14,855, an hourly close below that point would give us a new intraday sell signal for the TSX. Okay, folks, that is all for Wednesday morning. Have a great day, and we'll be back to speak to you again on Thursday morning.